So now we're going to talk about covalent bonding. So atoms can bond in by ionic bonding. Also atoms can bond by covalent bond. So atoms tend to come together by processes. One of them is covalent bonding. So in covalent bonding, basically what happens is that if you have an atom that is an atom tries to be stable. So if you have an atom like this and it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 outer shell, it's not stable, it wants to be stable. Another atom comes along, different or the same, and it also has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These two atoms are not stable. What happens is that they both come together. So you have something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This atom comes together like this, and you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So when they come together, they attach itself, so they become like one. So this atom, this atom looks like it has a full outer shell. This atom has a full outer shell, because now he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So they become stable. That's the whole idea of covalent bonding. So let's take an example, like say chlorine atom. How do we know how chlorine would bond? The formula for chlorine is Cl. We look at the periodic table. You look at chlorine. Chlorine is over here, 7. So you look at the group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If chlorine is in group 7, then that means that chlorine has 7 out in its outer shell. So you just 7 in the outer shell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And let's say chlorine can actually bond with another chlorine atom. So just say if another chlorine atom is going to have the same 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just like the last one we did, they would both come together and they would share. So they both have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 atoms. So let's take hydrogen. Hydrogen is the first element on the periodic table. Hydrogen tends to not want to exist by itself. Tends to bond with, because hydrogen has one electron in its outer shell. So hydrogen needs two to be stable. So how can hydrogen bond? Hydrogen can bond with, let's say, how can hydrogen bond to be stable? Well, hydrogen can bond things. What hydrogen can do is bond with another hydrogen atom to be stable, because it just needs two in its inner shell. That's it. So hydrogen can bond with another hydrogen, so you get H come together. See, they both share this electron by covalent bonding. This can also be written like this. This dot can be placed, so you get something like this. Or you can write like this, H2, two hydrogen bond together. So let's look at this NH3. NH3 is a covalent bond. So in this case, I give you a symbol. This is a covalent bond. So how does this look like? So what happens is, you look at where's nitrogen. N is what? N is nitrogen, and H3 is hydrogen, three hydrogen. So how does that bond take place? Well, we look at hydrogen. We'll want to look what's its outer shell. Well, hydrogen is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So hydrogen has 5 electrons in its outer shell. So it's your hydrogen. The first one is always the middle man. So the hydrogen, the first letter, is always the one that goes in the middle. So hydrogen goes in the middle. Hydrogen has 5 from here. Check it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hydrogen. So 5 in the outer shell. So you draw the outer shell, you draw 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Right? 5 in the outer shell. Now, hydrogen, well, in order for hydrogen to be, now hydrogen has 1 in its outer shell only. Hydrogen by itself just has 1 electron in its outer shell, Right, it just exists as that. So if you put hydrogen here, you won't get stable. You're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It needs 8 to be stable. So doing the math, that means it needs 1 hydrogen, 8. We'll give it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Another hydrogen will give it 7. Another hydrogen would give it 7. And another hydrogen would give it 8. So if you take 3 hydrogen and you bond it with 1 nitrogen, you get a stable element or compound, stable compound. So that's what's going to happen. These two are going to come together. So 1 hydrogen would come here. So now that side is stable. Another hydrogen would come here. And maybe another hydrogen might come here. So now hydrogen is stable. They have 2. And now nitrogen has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now nitrogen is stable. So it forms this compound, NH3. Right? This is a covalent bond. So in a covalent bond, you write the 3 at the bottom. So that's why nitrogen, this is written this way. Right? That's why this compound is written this way. It takes 3 hydrogen and 1 nitrogen to make up this thing. This is also can be written like this. N. This is an N. H. H. H.